Andiamo qui, la neve, get!
Handball is an attractive game. It is being played by 7 players. We have usually 4 referees. 2 we call them court players, then 2 on the bench aside. There is sizes in balls of handball. We have size 1 for kids, we have size 2 for ladies, and size 3 for men's category.
Handball was introduced in Uganda in 1973 by a gentleman called Paming Oneg. He had gone on other trainings, swimming and what have you. Then he saw the game of handball. He was a police officer. So it was being played in police, prisons. So later on, it went into army schools, police training schools. Later on, schools picked up, and eventually parastate was picked up. And finally, the universities also picked up.
Right now, as you're seeing, I'm on my way going to police handball grounds for a handball training. This is Police Children's School, and it's the home of Uganda Police Handball Club grounds, as you're seeing. We start usually at 2 for academy program, then at 4:30 we start our club training. Now I'm going to put on training kits so that I join my team, because I joined late, as you're seeing. The training is already on, so I'm going to put on, then I join the team for the training. As I told you, there is punishments in handball. I was given 2 minutes out because of an unnecessary foul on court. So it means you go out you rest for 2 minutes, then after 2 minutes you come back on court.
Handball is actually more interesting than any other sport played outdoor. But you find that we currently attract the lowest attention.
At one time, between 1995 and 90s, it was actually rated sport number 2 after football. There are 3 or 4 reasons that what led to handball backsliding. One was people thought that there was a lot of money in handball, so they ganged and threw away the administration which was there, which was headed by Sheila Richardson, okay, Agonziwa. When they realized that actually there was no money, it was the other way around, you had to put money in the sport, they quit. Then the second one was the fall of parastatals. We had Uganda Railways, Post Office and Telecommunication. We had Bank of Uganda, yeah, as the strongest pillars of the national teams. So when Uganda Railways was no more, Post Office no more, Bank of Uganda, the policy changed from sport, instead of having their own teams to sponsor differently. So now all the handball was left in forces. And forces have their limitations. Their level of recruitment, they don't recruit below 18, okay? And after recruitment, they maintain youth route. So they could have the same squad for some seasons.
we had many challenges. Some clubs don't have home grounds, what I can call handball courts. Some we share the home grounds. We don't have enough equipment like balls, cones, whistles, and the other kits. So far, clubs don't have enough money to maintain the teams as it's supposed to be.
What we've always wanted as council is to have the national stadium, Nambole, that has all the land around it, to have these kind of facilities there. For example, people who play volleyball and netball can use their facilities there. Currently, construction of the beach soccer facility is going to start at Nambole by end of this year, because Uganda is going to host the Africa Beach Soccer Championship at some point in 2020. Would love also handball to join in.
Samuju Frank Wine is trying to develop a handball game in Uganda. I started the Chivuli Handball Academy. Then it means every year we produce more than 20 players from primary level to secondary level, and we usually get them bursaries, sports bursaries, then from secondary level to university level. But when you see the system of our federation, they put nothing in development, so at times we are doing it at our own.
And it should be the clubs now to feed the federation, yeah. But what we pay as clubs to the federation, we subscribe, and it's only 150,000 per year as a subscription for membership. Then the other money we pay is for competition. You pay for the league, which is not even enough for the costs. So at the end of it, you find that good-hearted individuals have to come in.
But according to what I know, National Council is supposed to fund every federation accordingly, most especially in development. How comes that handball we don't receive anything? Yet we play international matches, international games. We have a national league. How comes? So if it's true that they receive nothing from National Council of Sports, then we have to question the National Council of Sports, what's the problem?
But I have provided budgets, I've provided whatever as a treasurer to National Council of Sports. And even today after this interview, that's where I'm going. Because I have a tournament coming up, I'm going to provide. But maybe I don't understand how they work.
While handball is not yet one of the priority sports, because government does fund 6 sports federations directly. That is football, netball, athletics, rugby, basketball, and then university sports. You can add Paralympics, people with disability. Those are 7 in all. But of course, the Paralympics is the sports they play under all the other federations. To be honest, over time, government did not find sport as a priority until 2 years ago, when government gave its first official budget for sport, which is 17.4 billion. And that was given for the financial 2017-2018, and it wasn't increased for the financial 2018-2019. Now, at the time when discussions were ongoing between the Minister of Finance, the Minister of Education, and President Museveni, he said, no, we cannot be able to do all these sports disciplines at once. Choose those that you feel are priority, that have competitions that are ongoing. At the time, most of the sports were chosen were those that were under the Olympic movement, because at the time, Uganda was preparing for the Olympics in Brazil.
I think federation officials can go back and sit down. They call a meeting for stakeholders, and we coaches, so that we plan for our future game.
We have a country that has a big problem of youth unemployment, and sport is an avenue that we can release some of the pressures of youth unemployment. We have a country that still wants to promote itself as a tourist destination. Sport is the best avenue for sports tourism. We feel that if there was more funding to enable most of our teams, not only athletics, not only football, to get the Handball Federation, for example, send teams to those kind of events, that would be a new avenue to get Uganda's tourism up there.
So I want in 5 to 10 years at least to be with a huge number of supporters in Uganda and everyone to be talking about handball.
In handball, we believe it's a family, so we leave the thing of, it is the federation, it's so and so, and we concentrate on one factor that it's our sport, it's all of us. You know, the Baganda have a saying that nyine mufu ya kwate waunya. So it's something we believe in. It's our game. Hey.